all your batting and all your skills with respect to first class cricket came from a Mumbai school. Then you moved on to Vidarbha. But you won a lot of Ranji titles with Mumbai and also with Vidarbha now. It must be two titles if I'm not wrong.
Yeah.
So, is there any constraint difference between the two places in terms of culture, or was it pretty seamless?
No, very, very different culture. Very, very vast difference, I would say. They had talent. You know, don't get me wrong, Vidarbha players. First of all, they don't have the pool of players that Mumbai has. Right. They've only got 25-30 good cricketers in Vidarbha, Nagpur, or maybe Baram, Kola or what else. There's some of another place. There's three or four places where the cricketers come from. So they don't have a very huge pool of players like Mumbai has. So the 25-30 players, they are very, very talented. When I went there for the first time, you know, I was surprised that, you know, the quality of their cricket, but the belief that, you know, a Mumbai cricketer or the confidence that a Mumbai cricketer has, I think they were missing that. Okay. The confidence in themselves and the confidence for them to, you know, go out there and beat good teams or probably find a way to win games. You know, even if they were in good position, they didn't believe as much, you know, as much as probably a Mumbai cricketer or a Karnataka cricketer would believe that, you know, they can get through this, they can find a way to win, or even if they're down, they'll bounce back. So they lack in that belief. I thought that belief probably changed when myself and Chandrakant Pandit came in and we kept talking about it and, you know, brought that culture into them. They were always very talented. They were always very hardworking. But, you know, they lacked all these things, you know, which you need to win games and which you need to win tournaments, I feel. And that came through, you know, when these things, you know, we started talking about and addressing those things. Then they started, you know, believing that, you know, no, we can beat good teams. We can beat, we can come out of any situation and, you know, still can win. So that perspective probably changed in those, you know, my 3-4 years with Vidarbha.
No, I mean, you obviously led me on to the next question. I'm actually so intrigued in this interview that I don't know which question to ask first. So you moved on from Mumbai to Vidarbha. Right, and you spoke of the soft skills, which is the confidence that a cricketer must possess, and what a Mumbai cricketer, you know, brings to the table, and how yourself and Pandit sir were able to make a difference. Beyond these soft skills, what is that one particular trait that you look for to iron out in a first-class team? Do you look for a fast bowler? Do you look for a spinner? What is that ingredient that a team requires, or is it the discipline and the practice culture? What is it, Vasim bhai?
I think if you ask me now, I would say that, you know, the temperament, you know, that I feel Ash holds very, very important. The khadus nature that we call, you know, that temperament, I feel that, you know, that I want this badly. Those kind of cricketers, I feel, are very, very important in building a team, in building a solid team. I think rest of the other things, you know, come through. You are talented, but, you know, if you don't have that temperament or you don't have that hunger to succeed or hunger to do well, I feel, I personally look for that, you know, those kind of players. Even if he's not as talented to the next guy, but if he has got that khadus nature or, you know, he's have ability to fight in crunch time, that makes a team, that makes a player, you know. And if you fine-tune those players, they turn out to become, you know, the players for the future. So I think if you're building a team, you need to find out those kind of characters, I feel, that, you know, who can do anything for the team. And I feel, you know, that culture that in Mumbai that we have is winning is everything. You know, no matter how much runs you score for yourself, how many wickets you take for your own self. But if you're not winning games or, you know, the team is not winning, then your performance don't hold that importance. So you need to bring that culture into the players that, you know, end of the day, winning is everything. So if you build that kind of culture around the players, I feel then you end up winning the championship.
100% agree. There is no better person to be talking about it. You played first class cricket for the last 23, 24 years, if I'm not wrong. And I don't know if you can even keep going on and on. And I don't see many bowlers dismissing you even today. But bringing into perspective, how much has first class cricket changed, Vasim bhai, from when you started till now? And you also spoke about this kadus nature of Mumbai cricket, right? So if I meet anybody in Mumbai cricket, they say kadus khelna, kadus khelna. So Can you just explain for the viewers' benefit about what this Kadu's nature is? Can it be taught?
I think the Kadu's nature, Ash, is about not giving it up. You know, as I said, not giving it up at all. You know, just finding a way to succeed, finding a way to win. You know, in no matter in what situation you are in, you could be, you know, 50 for 5, batting first. But finding a way, you know, that number 7, number 8, you know, not giving it up, you know, not giving it up easy to the opponent, not giving it easy to the bowlers or for the batsmen for that matter. That is the Kadu's nature. That is what we have been taught from the, you know, not that much from the school, but from the club cricket that we played. You know, finding a way, no matter what situation you are in. You know, the other team could be 200 for no loss or maybe 200 for one, but finding a way to, you know, break the, you know, the momentum or, you know, doing anything, you know, probably finding a way to run out a batsman, finding a way to, you know, take a brilliant catch, you know, or, you know, going in any situation and scoring those 20, 30 runs, the number 7, number 8 player, number 9 player, and winning. You know, that is what I mean, that, you know, finding a way, you know, and not giving it up in no situation whatsoever, not, that is the Kadu's nature that we were, you know, thought about. And the seniors also, if you give up at any situation and come out inside the dressing room, the senior players will let you know. You know, we have found, I can tell you many stories that, you know, even the two test players, they would tell you there and then that, boss, you know, you messed it up for the team. So the next time that guy knows that, boss, I have to pull my socks up. You know, no matter where I'm playing, because I've seen my seniors, you know, Sachin Tendulkar or Sanjay Manjrekar or anybody, you know, Dilip Venkatkar, when they come into the Mumbai dressing room after playing from Indian circle, they are as hard as, you know, they were playing for Indian team. You know, I remember, you know, a story when Sunil Gavaskar came back from New Zealand and the Mumbai team were going to play Maharashtra in a Ranji semi-final, and he came to drop his players at the railway station. He was not playing that game, but he came to drop his players. So you can imagine the commitment level, you know, of the players. So that is the stories and that is the culture that, you know, we have been brought up with. And no matter who you're playing against, you know, you have to find a way, you know, even if it's, I mean, I can remember in 1971, you know, the stories that we have, that, you know, the Mumbai Indian, the Indian team were in West Indies 1971 when Gavaskar made his debut. So 8 of the Mumbai players were playing for the Indian team in West Indies. And Mumbai was playing a Ranji Trophy final against Maharashtra at CCI. All new players. You know, Sudhir Naik was leading the side. All newcomers, 8 of the, you know, the current players were not playing. Ajit Wadekar, Eknath Solkar, you know, name it. Dilip Sardesai, Sunil Gavaskar. So all new players played that Ranji final and still went out to win the tournament. So that is the culture. You know, that is the culture that we have brought up. No matter who's playing against you, you have to find a way to win. And that actually made the Mumbai cricket what it is.
No, it's unbelievable. 8 new players to come in and play and win a Ranji Trophy title is no joke. And the lead into that question, how much has cricket, first class cricket, changed, Vaseem Bhai? Has the landscape changed much at all? Or what do you think? And if you have to make one suggestion to a team that is looking to win a Ranji Trophy, what would that be?
I think, you know, the cricket has definitely got better. Asha, don't get me wrong. The cricket has become better. Cricket has become, you know, very positive. You know, the changes have become better, you know, now that, you know, the scoring rates have improved, the, you know, the confidence level of the players has improved. I think the spin quality has come down definitely, and I've told that many a times, but, you know, I can't blame the spinners because they are playing the T20 cricket so much. So they can't be bowling like, you know, what they were bowling in the 90s or probably, you know, early 2000s. So I can understand where they're coming from, but I think the quality of spin bowling has definitely come down from what I have grown up in. The quality of fast bowling has definitely improved. You know, the quality of pitches, I feel, you know, we're playing on better pitches nowadays. Batting definitely has improved. You know, batting has gone to another level in India. So, you know, the cricket is definitely improving. You know, the spin department that I'm saying is, you know, nowadays you can't tell a spinner to, you know, toss the ball up like in the 90s or 80s, because the batsmen are so confident, you know, even if you keep the field in the boundaries, they are still, you know, they still have that confidence and they still have that belief that they can clear the boundaries easily. And if you keep scoring, if you keep hitting those sixes, the spinners are bound to, you know, bowl a different trajectory, different line and length. So I can't blame them. Earlier, the spinners used to, you know, think about getting the batsman out. You know, nowadays, the more, you know, the spinners are thinking about, you know, restricting the batsman, because they know if he restricts the batsman, he's going to get a wicket in the return. So I also don't think that is a bad thing, because the patience level has come down in a batsman. If you bowl, you know, in a particular span, if you bowl 10 good overs, you're bound to get some opportunities. So I don't think that is also wrong. It is the need of the hour or the time that we are playing in. So I think the cricket in general, I feel, is improved quite a lot. You know, the first class cricket is definitely going in the right direction.
Wow, amazing. Because there is, I was speaking to Amol, and the same thing is connected. He told me all of you are on a Zoom call or WhatsApp call sometime back. And he also said the same thing. And he said, spin bowling standard has definitely dropped. And he said, maybe it's because a lot of pitches are having grass in our intention to want to improve our seam bowling and batting against seam. We might have lost out a bit of spin. So, he suggested that we play first-class cricket on 5-day format. Is that something you would agree?
I don't think it's a bad move to play, because you'll get more results, I feel. You'll definitely get more results. It's only the only problem, I would say, that, you know, fitting those five-day games into this tight calendar, that is going to be a problem. But if it can happen, I think it's going to give you, you know, the more teams, I feel the better teams will win more matches. Even if it's a green pitch, for instance, and you lose the toss and you bat first, I think in a 5-day game, you get more chances of coming back into the game. In a 4-day game, you don't get that much time. You know, if the wickets become better, the other team gets 100, 200 runs lead, and there's not much time space for you to, you know, score runs quickly and give the opponents another chance. But I think in 5-day game, you can have that liberty, even if you, you know, lose the toss, to come back into the game. So if BCCI can do that, you know, well and good. But I was saying, you know, about the spinners were from the spinners' mentality. I wasn't speaking much about from the batsman's mentality. You know, nowadays when I see some of the games that India played on the spin, you know, friendly pitches in India, and I see a lot of Indian batsmen struggling. You know, a lot of people struggled against. I remember that South African series, or I think it was an Australian series. So a lot of our players also struggled against the quality of spin bowling. I mean, I remember Graham Swan and Monty when they bowled well. So because I think, you know, we don't play on those kind of wickets also. You know, that is one of the reasons. Because we give so much importance on winning abroad. So when you're playing abroad, you're bound to get, you know, the green pitches and the seaming pitches, so, which is also, I feel, it's not wrong. But in our time, we used to play on a lot of Turner wickets. You know, the third or fourth day, the pitches would become, you know, really big turners. Okay. That doesn't happen. That doesn't very often. You know, again, I would say that, you know, when you start your first class season is also important. When I played last season, we started in December. So, you're not going to get a lot of turning wickets in December. That's why a lot of teams didn't score that many runs. A lot of good batsmen didn't score that many runs. Because you're playing on green pitches, on cold conditions. So, I feel, you know, I also said in a couple of my interviews that, you know, you have to make sure that, you know, you start your Ranji Trophy season in October. Because a lot of first-class teams, they have their pre-season from July or, you know, July. They go to Bucci Babu, which is a 3-day tournament. They go to KSTA, which is a 4-day tournament. And then they play all these tournaments as a team. And suddenly the BCCI puts a Mushtaq Ali as a first tournament. So what happens? You know, all those preparations go to waste. You know, you don't play in July and August. You don't play any T20 tournament as a preparation. So when you play KSTA, when you play Bucci Babu, why not continue with the same momentum and play the Ranji Trophy first? Because all the players then can identify the players they want to play in Ranji Trophy. Because Ranji Trophy is played over 2.5-3 months. So that continuity has to improve. Suddenly you have a World Cup in between 50-over World Cup, and they'll think about putting Vijay Hazare first. But how many times the Indian selectors select a Vijay Hazare player in the Indian team, even if he has got 800 runs in the tournament? That's not going to happen. If somebody scores 500 runs in Mushtaq Ali, he's not going to get fit in the Indian team. Unless he scores runs in India A or in the IPL. So I feel that continuity has to be there so the team, even the selectors, even the coaches know that, you know, in October we are starting the season with the 4-day tournament and then we are going to play probably Mushtaq Ali because the IPL auction is going to be held so the franchise can look into their, you know, draft of players. And then end the season with Vijay Hazare. So that becomes, that can, the teams and the selectors and the coaches then can plan accordingly.
Wow, interesting. You nailed the point. And obviously the lack of time, 12 months don't seem to be enough for us at this point of time.
Yeah.
One final question before we part away, Vasim bhai. It has been accelerating so far. You just owned the coach's hat, right? You got into Kings 11 as a batting coach this year and all that. If you happen to take a first-class team up to coach, what is that first thing or the most important thing that you would do with that team if you're serious about winning a Ranji Trophy?
I think I told you before, Ash. I think the first thing I would, address is the discipline within the team. Everybody comes together as a team and all the importance should be given to winning the game, you know. And then picking the character that, you know, thing that, you know, has that temperament to succeed at the top level, you know, in that crunch moment, who doesn't crack, you know, and finding those players, finding those kind of characters, you know, who can make the team. And then investing in time in them and then, you know, the skill set obviously after that. But finding those characters, you know, who plays for the team and who has that kind of, you know, mentality that, you know, winning is everything. And that discipline within the group. You know, if you have, if there is a lot of difference between the seniors and the juniors and, you know, this player can do whatever he wants, that player can do whatever he wants. I think the team doesn't run like that. So you need to understand, you know, and management part of it. But I think, you know, discipline within the group and, you know, winning. I feel that, you know, you have to instill in the players that, you know, winning is everything. Once they start believing that, if I'm batting, for instance, if I'm batting on 100 and we are chasing a 400 and our team is on 200 for two, for instance. So I need to not worry about my 100 because I've done the job for myself. You know, I've done the job for myself. I'm sure about my, you know, next 2-3 games. But my 100 probably is not enough at this point. Probably if I get another 170, probably another 70 runs and get past that 400, that is what I mean. You know, you have to think like that. You know, getting past that 400, I need to probably bat another 2 sessions.
Right.
And getting past that 400 mark. You know, so those kind of things, you probably got 100 or you probably have got 5 wickets, but probably getting another 2 wickets at that point is more important for your own performance than for the team. So if you instill that, I feel, in the players, then I think most of your job is done.
Vasim bhai, this has absolutely been fabulous. Not just to watch you play. I'm sure a lot of young kids have learned what it is to bat for long periods and learned from this interview. But I also think a lot of teams would have learned how exactly to approach a campaign. You have been a fabulous player, one of my favorites across in India. And I have no doubts that you'll be an absolutely stunning coach, Vasim bhai. All the very best for your coaching career.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Vasim bhai.
Thank you very much. Pleasure.